Welcome. You're watching Market at Start on Money Control. I'm Sakshi Batra, and this is where we get you prepared for the trading setup of the day. I also have with me Kshitijan, Markets Editor at Money Control. Good morning, Kshitijan. Thanks very much for joining in on the first trading day of this week. Well, the last week has been spectacular as we speak for the markets, for the Sensex and the Nifty. We've seen above 2.5% rise for both the indices on a week-on-week basis, and we've also seen record high levels on the Sensex as well. What are the big cues that you're looking at for this week now?
Morning, Sachi, and good morning, viewers. Definitely, you know, I would say it was a historic week for Indian markets. You know, if you look at the performance, and Sensex rose by 2.8%, Nifty saw a rally of 2.6%. But what was important was the fact that Sensex hit a fresh record high of 40,392. So that is definitely a good sign. But then, you know, the rally sort of fizzled out on Thursday as well as on Friday. But what could really, what could really hurt investor sentiment at this point in time could be the GST numbers, which has actually come around about 95,000 crores, which is slightly lower than on a year-on-year figure, and definitely lower than the 1 lakh crore mark that the government is targeting at this point in time. Now, apart from that, auto sales were also slightly muted, Sakshi.
Right.
And that was, in fact, one of the key reasons why, we saw a slight bit of, dampening of sentiments on Thursday as well as on Friday.
Sure.
In fact, auto sales number from Tata Motors were also not that great.
Right.
So definitely we could see some bit of, profit taking at high levels, which would come in today's trading session as well. But given the fact that, global cues remain positive because of there's some hopes of trade deal between US and China.
Yeah.
So definitely that could really aid the rally, and we could retest, 11,900 levels, in today's trading session. We had a touch and go moment on Friday.
Sure.
But then again, we could probably, retest those levels. Apart from that, foreign institutional investors were again net buyers in Indian markets. Not just on Friday, but in fact for the month of October as well, they poured in more than 16,000 crores, including equity as well as debt. And the rupee also appreciated slightly against the US dollar. So all in all, I think we have a mixed setup at this point in time, but most of it is pointing towards on the upside.
Absolutely. Macro positives will be definitely important to watch out for today, because that is expected to lend some supporting hand to the Indian equities as well as far as the global equities are concerned. But then when you talk about the domestic markets, the focus will be again on the earnings front. We have a whole lot of large cap and mid cap companies that will be reporting earnings today. So right. Kshitij, which are the top earnings that you're keeping on your radar?
Right. In fact, around about 60 companies on the BSE will be declaring their results for the September quarter. Now, the prominent one being HDFC. Here, the net profit is likely to grow by 36% on a year-on-year basis. And for the Godrej Agrovet, the net profit is likely to grow by nearly 2% on a year-on-year basis. Now, remember, both these estimates are from Motilal Oswal.
Absolutely. Then again, on the technical front, it will be very important to watch out for as to what will be the key levels for the index, as well as what are the technical patterns suggesting to us as far as this week is concerned and the trade is concerned for this week. So, Kshitij, help us with what kind of patterns have developed last week,
right,
and what do they indicate for this week now, and how should traders position themselves really?
Right. In fact, if you look at trading pattern, or in fact the chart pattern formed on Friday, that was a doji kind of a pattern. And we've seen this indecisiveness patterns for the last three trading sessions, be it Wednesday, Thursday and Friday. Now, which really point towards the fact that we could have made a top in place. Now, given the fact that we had a touch and go moment with 11,900 on Friday, the global setup, if you look at the global setup at this point in time, they remain fairly supportive. So we could, in fact, reclaim that 11,900 comfortably in today's trading session. But what investors should understand is that the crucial moving averages or the crucial levels to watch out for probably in today's trading session would be Friday's intraday low of 11,843 as well as 11,800 levels. So in case we do breach this level on the downside, then there could be a possibility of further selling, further consolidation taking place. In case we surpass 11,918, 11,950 levels, which was the intraday high formed in Friday's trading session, I think the uptrend will still remain intact. And we should be able to, head higher, retest 11,980 and 12,000 levels, in today's trading session or probably in the week. Now, remember, if you look at the rollovers, Sakshi, for the November series, they were fairly strong.
Yeah.
And that also gives us that kind of confidence that, bulls are not going to give up that easy.
Yeah.
So definitely, even at lower levels, we could see some bit of buying coming in, which could help Nifty and Sensex again to test new fresh highs. But yes, probably once Nifty touches a fresh record high, we could see fizzling out of rally, because there are no major cues, because we're also heading towards a holiday season.
Sure.
December again is a very lean period. Foreign institutional investors are mostly on holidays.
Yeah.
So that could also play a crucial role as we move towards towards the end of 2019.
Absolutely. So that is very important to watch out for as far as the technical levels are concerned for both the Nifty and the Sensex as well. We'll just have to see what kind of trend FIs really continue. Do they continue to be net buyers for us for the entire November month or not? That'll be very important to watch out for, to really figure out how the 2019 calendar year will really end. But apart from this, a whole lot of other stocks will be in focus because of the kind of earnings they have reported and on the back of news flows as well. So Shitish, the top stocks on your list today?
Right. The first stock that I have on the list is Yes Bank. Now, investors which are in discussion with Yes Bank to pump in capital of around $3 billion. The bank said on November 1st, now remember, Yes Bank, saw a double-digit kind of a rally on Friday's trading session, largely around this news. Now, the bank had disclosed that one of the investors in discussion is for around about $1.2 billion capital is family office in the U.S. Now, Yes Bank also posted a loss of around about 600 crores. Macquarie maintains an underperform rating on the stock with a target of around about 50. Tata Motors on Friday reported 33% decline in total sales at 41,354 units for the month of October. Apart from that, Dr. Reddy's will be in focus. Now, the pharma major doubled its profit to 1,093 crores for the September quarter, compared to 504 crores reported in the year-ago period. Now, Citigroup maintains a sell rating on the stock and slashed the target price to 2,375 from 2,600 earlier. Apart from that, Nomura maintains a buy rating on Dr. Reddy's with a target price of 3,284. Now, I believe, Sakshi, you're also tracking some stocks based on what brokerages are recommending.
Absolutely, Shitish. So, auto sales will be definitely very important to watch out for. They began coming out with their sales numbers for the month of October on the 1st of November. And basis on that, brokerage houses have come out with their reports. Let's talk about Nomura's report on the auto sales numbers for the October 2019 month. Now, for the volumes, they say the passenger vehicles were down about 1%. And for two-wheelers and for medium and heavy commercial vehicles, the volumes were down 14% and also 49% on a year-on-year basis. However, you need to remember that the volume decline was definitely lower when you compare it for the past few months. Remember, in the fiscal 2019 so far, we have not seen major companies or major auto companies really report growth in their sales numbers or massive growth. There's just been like about a flat growth or maybe negative volume growth as well. But October month has still been better because of the kind of festival sales that we have seen. Now, industry retails were much higher when you talk about the when you compare it to the wholesales due to the festive season as well. Now, in tractors, M&M really disappointed with volumes down 4% year-on-year. And Nomura has a buy recommendation on M&M and also Ashok Leyland. However, it maintains a reduced rating on Eicher Motors and TVS Motors. So, likewise, you'll be able to see some reaction on these stocks as well. And apart from this, we also have some technical recommendations for you. So, Shitish, who have you spoken to and what do we have?
Right. So, in fact, well, to make your day more profitable, we spoke to ICICI Direct and they've given us two recommendations, and that is not for for today or for 1 week, it is for 6 months. The first stock that they have on the list is KEC International. Now, that's a buy for a target of 334 and a stop loss of 248. Pidilite Industries, now that's also a buy for a target of 1,680 and a stop loss of 1,282. Now, remember, the return potential is close to 20% on all these stocks, both these stocks. These are not intraday trading ideas, but more of a positional play. So, in case you initiate any positions based on these recommendations, well, do consult your financial advisor.
Right. Thanks a lot, Shitish, for sharing these ideas with us. And with that, it's a wrap here on this edition of Market Head Start. You stay logged on to moneycontrol.com for more news and updates. Thanks for watching.
Thank you.